In this video, we are going to talk about the connection between a fatty liver and heart attack. Most of the times, we do not think in this direction, that is, a fatty liver can cause heart attack. We are just worried that if we have fat inside our liver cells, it may lead to things like cirrhosis or liver cancer. But that is true only in 5 to 20% of the cases. Majority of the times, what happens that when you have a condition like fatty liver, where there is accumulation of fat cells inside the liver, what happens that it causes release of pro-inflammatory cells in your blood vessels. So rather than causing inflammation of your hepatocytes, which are the healthy liver cells, these fatty liver will cause inflammation of your arteries. We call that as subclinical or low-grade systemic inflammation. And that is the first step in the pathogenesis of heart attack. Most of the physicians or cardiologists are just concerned with cholesterol, which gets deposited on your this damaged part, and that is actually a protective mechanism. So rather than concentrating on the subclinical or systemic low-grade inflammation, most of the physicians are just concerned with cholesterol, and that is a wrong direction in preventing heart attack. If you want to prevent heart attack, you have to address this thing, that is low-grade systemic inflammation. So keep in mind that the fat cells, they store a lot of toxins. And when these toxins get released into your systemic circulation, what happens that this will cause low-grade systemic inflammation. And over a period of time, this will result in the complete blockage, resulting in heart attack or stroke or kidney failure, depending upon your genes also. So you want to know your this thing, that is, if you have a fatty liver or not, in your early 30s, so that you do not get heart attack when you reach your 40s. So you have to go and visit your doctor and rule out this condition, especially if you have a familial history of heart attack. This is very, very important. Now, what is the common thing between these two, that is fatty liver and heart attack? It is metabolic syndrome, the prevalence of which is very much high in country like India. And this is because a lot of people are insulin resistant. So insulin resistance can cause low-grade systemic inflammation, can cause fatty liver, and all these things can lead to heart attack. So in my recommendation, you should be visiting your doctor in your early 30s, rule out things like fatty liver, know your fasting insulin, know your triglyceride and VLDL and lipoprotein A. So you should be knowing all these things, especially if you have a familial history of heart attack. Now, fatty liver, what happens that they not only cause some clinical inflammation of your blood vessels, but they also alter your gut microbiota, which is again very important in controlling the inflammation, systemic inflammation, because a healthy gut generates less amount of toxins. As a result of that, there is no inflammation of your blood vessels. But if you have fatty liver, that can affect your, that can alter your gut microbiota, so your gut will also be unhealthy, and as a result of that, there will be increasing inflammation, increasing systemic inflammation, causing heart attack. And unhealthy liver and unhealthy gut, they generate a lot of trimethylamine and oxide, which is again a contributing factor in the pathogenesis of heart attack. So what you can do as preventive measure? See, the worst thing for your liver is too much prescription drugs or even supplements. So even the so-called safe supplements or Ayurvedic or naturopathic supplements can actually harm your liver. So you should be very, very cautious when you are trying to take any supplement or any prescription drugs. And in India, you can take drugs like antibiotics or even steroids without doctor's prescription. And that is actually very, very harmful for your liver. Next important thing is too much calorie consumption. So when your body is in a chronic state of calorie surplus, that can also cause fatty liver. Then if you have take drugs like for lowering cholesterol, like statins, that can actually harm your liver. So this can actually, over a period of time, lead to heart attack rather than preventing heart attack. Thing that is very bad for liver is fructose. So too much fructose consumption can also harm your liver cells. And we get too much fructose from all those junk foods where they add high fructose corn syrup. So that is also very, very bad for liver. So what you can do to prevent heart attack? See, the number one important thing is diet. So your diet should be a well-balanced diet, and the worst things should be avoided, like trans fat. Trans fat compete with omega-3 for absorption, and omega-3 is very, very important in improving your insulin sensitivity. So if you are deficient in omega-3, what it can do is not only it can cause fatty liver, but it can also cause heart attack. Next thing is you want to get abundant of magnesium. Magnesium is very, very crucial, especially when you are stressed. When you are stressed, you deplete a lot of magnesium. Magnesium is the tonic for your heart. Magnesium also improves insulin sensitivity and prevents fatty liver. So get abundant omega-3 and abundant electrolytes, especially magnesium and potassium, through your diet. Next thing is sunlight. You want to get enough vitamin D, because vitamin D affects every cell of your body, and vitamin D is concerned with improving insulin sensitivity as well as preventing the hardening of your arteries, and it ensures that there is smooth circulation inside your blood vessels so that you do not suffer from heart attack. And if you think that you cannot get enough sunlight, you should consider adding a vitamin D3 supplement. Next important thing is being in a state of calorie deficit. Calorie deficit. This can be achieved by either fasting, exercise, and eating less portion. Portion control, that is also going to help you. So you can achieve calorie deficit by these things. Next important thing here is getting enough antioxidants, because when you have fatty liver, what it leads to is increasing oxidative stress, and that can actually be very, very bad for your heart. So the fatty liver will lead to decreasing antioxidant. So what you should be doing is you should be consuming lots of antioxidant rich foods. And one of the best ways to improve your antioxidant level is exercise. This exercise actually improves your antioxidant level, and it also improves your insulin sensitivity. So it's very, very useful in preventing heart attack. And again, exercise should be according to your age, according to your strength, according to how you feel. It should not be a mean to, you know, show off. So getting enough sleep. Now sleep is essential because it is going to decrease your stress hormones like cortisol. So cortisol is also concerned with causing inflammation of your arteries, and if your cortisol is always high, it can cause inflammation of your arteries, and it can over a period of time cause blockage. So you want to get enough good quality sleep, 6 to 8 hours depending upon your age. So these are things that you can do to prevent heart attack in your 40s by ruling out fatty liver in your 30s.